This is Susan Bradley, the Microsoft Patch Lady for Computer World. In the United States, we're coming up to a major holiday, that of the eating holiday, Thanksgiving. And it's typically a time that I schedule maintenance jobs, and especially at home, I look to see the security and also the update progress on my home computers. Normally, I wait until the Friday after Thanksgiving in order to do any major projects. Even at home, I take that time to make sure my system is up to date and everything is set as I want it. At this time, I'm ready to give the all clear to go ahead and install any updates if you haven't already installed them. Now, granted, I'd probably wait and do it after your Thanksgiving Zoom get-together first and then install any updates. I'd hate to see you see nothing but the spinning wheel of the Windows update process instead of your family and friends. 2004 and 2008.2, better known as 2009, is still seeing some lingering installation bugs. It's not so much that you're seeing side effects from the installation of patches, but more lingering side effects of the feature release itself. One major pain point for business patchers that use WSUS, SCCM, or other patching tools was when they updated from a previous feature release to either 2004 or 2008.2, it lost the certificate. This is very painful, especially in regards to VPN and other processes. Now, for home users that use Windows Update to go from the feature releases, you won't see this issue. So again, you may see this information in the news, but it does not impact home or consumer patchers that use the Windows Update process. The good news is, for business patchers, this issue has been fixed. I'm still tracking an issue where what's called an in-place upgrade, where if you have a Windows 10 machine that's causing some issues, you can use an in-place upgrade process to fix those issues. With Windows 2008.2, there's a bug where it won't let you do that. They'll be fixing that issue in the December release of Windows 10 and updating the ISOs at that time. Now, I recommend if you've been seeing any issues with slowdowns or issues on your Windows 10 machine that you try to uninstall any third-party antivirus and reinstall it. In particular for home and consumer users, I find that Windows Defender is usually better suited to keep up to handling these feature releases. Any other product might be a little bit behind the 8-ball. Remember, if you're on version 1903, it goes out of service on December 8, 2020. So you'll want to make sure you're on version 1909 or later at that time. Remember, you can use a setting called the Targeted Release Version in order to ensure you stay on a specific feature release. You can use either group policy or a registry key in order to set that setting. Now, I recommend that you do not use the home version of Windows 10, that you upgrade to Windows 10 Pro, because it's always my philosophy that you have a lot more ability to control patching with the Pro version versus the home. Recently, Microsoft re-released KB4023057. Now, this is the update that makes sure that your system is ready to go for the next feature release. It checks on hard drive space, checks on Windows Update components, and in general, make sure your system is clean and ready to go. If you see this offered up to your machine, don't worry. It's just making sure that you're set and ready for the next feature release. Speaking of antivirus, recently Malwarebytes released a new version because there was an issue where users could not see local area network attached devices or in the network neighborhood after upgrading to CU19. If you use NAS devices and you cannot see that device and you use Malwarebytes, make sure you're up to date on your antivirus. Now, my final tip is just for business patchers. That is, those people that use a Windows server or domain controller in their environment. It's a specific role, and the domain controller hands out authentication information for all of the workstations in the environment. Recently, there was a patch that patched Kerberos KDC security. And as a result, a side effect was generated, especially with federated Recently, there was a side effect introduced with federated authentication service in a Citrix environment. As a result, several out-of-band patches were released to specifically fix this issue. These releases are not up on Windows Update, nor are they out on WSUS. You have to manually go to the catalog in order to download them and install them in your environment. They're only needed to update on your domain controllers. Again, these are specifically for servers, only for domain controllers. Now, at this time, I'm still scratching my head and not quite understanding what I need to do to be fully patched with this update. In addition to the patch being installed, there's also a registry key that needs to be set. And I'm honestly still a bit confused as to what I need in my environment. The information in the KB article says that, by default, the registry key, when it's not set, will be the value of 1. That is, the fix is enabled on the domain controller, but the domain controller does not require the tickets conform to the fix. I'm still confused as to what I need in my environment to be safe and protected. This only impacts constrained delegation, and I honestly do not have that setting in my environment, so I'm not sure if I need these registry keys. Bottom line, I'll be looking more into this and hope to get an answer for you back soon so that we all can be more secure. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful holiday season, and stay safe and stay patched.